By a show of hands, how many of you have heard the term downward spiral? Almost everyone? We know what it looks like. We lose our jobs, or go through a breakup, or have a health issue. So we start to stress eat, and we have trouble sleeping. And because we haven't slept well, we're impatient and short-tempered with our friends, our family, our coworkers. And then we're ashamed about our behavior, so we withdraw from our relationships, which causes us to engage in even more self-destructive behaviors. One bad thing leads to another, and the force of the spiral propels us further downward, damaging ourselves and those around us. Now, by a show of hands, how many of you have heard of the term upward spiral? You see maybe three shaky hands? The principle is the same. One small change sparks a cascade of other changes, but this time in a positive direction. It's similar to the butterfly effect or a positive feedback loop. For example, research from Dr. Barbara Friedrichsen and her colleagues found that engaging in loving kindness meditation incites an upward spiral. Now, to give a little background, loving kindness meditation is based on the Buddhist practice of metta meditation, which aims to increase feelings of love and compassion for all beings. Friedrichsen and her team found that just a few weeks of engaging in this kind of meditation causes us to feel more positive emotions. And when we're feeling more positive emotions, that causes us to feel more socially connected, which leads to our bodies being more resilient to stress, which improves our heart health. So meditation, for just a few weeks, improves our emotions, relationships, mental health, and physical health. And what's more, Friedrichsen and her team found that these benefits are reciprocally reinforcing. So the effect grew stronger over time. Now, this one example shows only a few components of upward spirals, but the rewards of upward spirals extend far deeper within ourselves and farther out into our relationships, our communities, and even our ecosystem. If we look at increased resilience to stress, when we're more resilient to stress, our immune system functions better. We're less likely to catch the common cold, but we're also more resistant to cancer and other chronic diseases. And when we're more resilient to stress, we sleep better. And when the quality of our sleep is improved, our mental health is boosted. We're less likely to develop anxiety or depression. If we look at positive emotions, when we're feeling more positive emotions, we're more likely to turn our attention outward and engage in acts of kindness for other people. When we engage in acts of kindness for others, our close, loving relationships deepen and strengthen. And when those relationships deepen and strengthen, we're more likely to live longer and have higher life satisfaction. Close, loving relationships are the best predictor of longevity and life satisfaction, even beyond things like income, whether or not we smoke, diet and exercise, and genetics. And research from the Framingham Heart Study shows us that when we're feeling more positive emotions and we're happier, that happiness is socially contagious. This effect can be so strong that we can boost the happiness of people 3 degrees of separation away from us, our friends, 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 people that we don't even know. In addition to improving our relationships, positive emotions and meditation make it more likely that we believe in climate change and engage in environmentally friendly behaviors. So let's say we choose to walk or bike to work instead of driving. We're simultaneously reducing the emissions that we put out into the atmosphere and improving our physical fitness. If we choose to purchase organic produce, we're reducing the amount of pollution that we put into our soil and our watershed and into our own bodies. And if we choose to add houseplants to our home or plant native trees and bushes in our yards, we are contributing to global greening and boosting our mental health because spending time in green space is good for our mental health. So I had to choose a semi-straightforward pathway through all of these benefits to explain them, but the truth is they are deeply intertwined. Kindness improves our mental health. Loving relationships improves the quality of our sleep, and spending time in green space boosts our immune system. It's a densely tangled web of positive influence. And upward spirals aren't only in our day-to-day actions. They're hardwired into our brains. Each time we engage in any of these behaviors or patterns of thought, the neurological pathways for those behaviors and patterns of thought strengthen, making it easier for us to use and maintain those pathways. And the spiral blooms further. and I've lived this story. I experienced an intense downward spiral my first year of college. I was chronically stressed, constantly sick, and totally neglected my relationships. I often woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning and couldn't fall back asleep. I thought I just needed to work harder and achieve my way through it, as if somehow status and success would fix my problems. I was lonely and unhealthy and wasteful and pretty miserable. I knew something needed to change. Immediately after I experienced this downward spiral, I experienced an upward spiral. I was drawn to meditation and had heard a lot of buzz about it in news articles and books and even in my classes. And I grew up on a lake where I've always derived a lot of peace from the stillness and the quiet. My life at that time was nothing but still or quiet. So hoping I might find that kind of peace, I started to meditate, just 8 to 10 minutes a day. It took time and many missed days that I berated myself for. But slowly, I learned to be more mindful and self-compassionate. I learned to listen to my emotions and what my body was telling me it needed. And after I learned to listen, I learned to respond, which took even longer. But over that next year, I started sleeping better. I felt more engaged in my classes. My relationships deepened and strengthened. I had more energy, so I started volunteering. And I started to look outward. I cared more about the climate and began my journey to zero waste. Overall, I felt a lot more joy and contentment. We live in a uniquely intimidating moment with daunting issues like climate change, systemic racism, the mental health epidemic. It can be easy to feel like we're doomed, especially because these issues are deeply interconnected and feed off of each other. But the upward spiral model allows us to see that because these issues are deeply interconnected, the solutions to these issues are also deeply interconnected. Remedies to systemic racism tend to also benefit our mental health and our climate. However, most of us are completely unaware of the power that we have to spark upward spirals for ourselves and the living and non-living beings around us. This is possible for all of us. Now, I don't expect everyone to be in an upward spiral all the time. I know that's unrealistic. There are lots of external forces that impact our lives, and we need the bad moments in life along with the good ones. But imagine if just 50% of us were engaged in an upward spiral. Imagine the transformations that we can see within ourselves, our society, and our planet. The power of upward spirals is within us all. But what's more exciting to me, it's in the space between us, too. My power is contagious, and so is yours. Thank you.